What's going on, internet? It's good to be back. For those of you who are wondering, production went exceptionally well. We were shooting for a fucking month straight with absolutely no days off, aside from Labor Day. And it was absolutely maddening, and I almost lost my mind at several points, but I had an amazing cast and crew to help me out, and I can't wait for y'all to see it when it's done. Now that that's out of the way, let's talk about Mother.
Please, come in. Hello.
Hello. He's a stranger. We're just gonna let him sleep in our house. Hello.
Hello.
You'll have to bear with me for this review because talking about this movie is going to be exceptionally difficult because all of my negatives have to do with things that are very spoilerific. So I will warn you when the time comes to talk about those things. Mother is directed by Darren Aronofsky, and it stars Jennifer Lawrence and Javier Bardem, and it tells the story of a couple living in an idealistic cabin in the woods, and I guess it's a house, and a bunch of people start showing up and messing shit up, and Jennifer Lawrence isn't happy about it. That's the version I can give that doesn't spoil anything. This movie's fucking insane. And I don't just mean that in a good way. Darren Aronofsky is a great director. I think that Requiem for a Dream, while absolutely devastating, is a fantastic movie. It's honestly in my top 10 movies ever. Black Swan is also fantastic. He is a very talented guy, and him making a movie that can technically be classified as horror is something that I was really interested in seeing. And now that I've seen it, it's a movie. It was a movie. Jennifer Lawrence, as expected, is great. She gives a really impassioned performance. It's really, really raw and emotional, and I think she did a really great job. I have heard rumors that she was so disturbed by this movie she threw the script out after. I don't really see why, but I mean, whatever. I can definitely understand given the places this movie takes her to, I can understand it being something she'd want to try and put behind her. Enough to forgive the changing lighting, guys. My room's a fucking mess right now, so my setup is a little different. Javier Bardem also gives a really cool performance as the somewhat neglectful husband of hers who is just really desperately trying to write his poetry and he just really wants to finish this one poem he's writing. Technically speaking, too, this film is really exceptionally well made. I mean, Darren Aronofsky, like I said, is just a really talented director, and I'm not surprised that, given how uncomfortable this movie is meant to make the audience, he uses a lot of really cool camera tricks in order to really make you feel just uneasy and kind of want to hold your legs closer to you. There's a lot of extended takes. There's a lot of really sweeping camera movements. There's a lot of very, very, very close, tight shots on people's faces and a lot of movement in terms of both performers and camera, and at times it could get a little dizzying and a little nauseating, and I definitely think people with motion sickness are gonna have a problem with this movie, but that's beside the point. It does work in the sense that it really delivers the overall discomfort that it's trying to, and I like that a lot. That being said, let's talk about the negative aspects, which really all boil down to one thing. This movie is fucking pretentious. And I don't like throwing that word around a lot, but that is the only word that applies here. This movie is so up its own ass, and it's, for lack of a better description, it's Darren Aronofsky jerking himself off for 2 hours. I'm going to be real here. There's so much I want to say that I can't say without spoiling it. I'll leave it at this without spoilers. This movie is begging you to interpret it. And it's all one great big metaphor. The problem with that is it's so heavy-handed with everything that it's trying to get across. And it's so awkward. And it leaves no room for interpretation whatsoever, despite the fact that it wants you to interpret it. It is so obvious what this film is about from the half hour mark onward to the point where by the ending, you just know exactly what is fucking coming because it's It's very predictable if you understand what it's trying to say, which it doesn't really make it difficult for you to understand what it's trying to say. It's shoving the fucking metaphor down your throat for 2 hours. Overall, I don't regret seeing it. I think it was fine. It was the textbook definition of a fine movie. It wasn't bad. It was not nearly as bad as some of the reviews are making it out to be. It's not good, really. It's just sort of okay. I don't regret seeing it. I probably could have waited until it came to home video and I really wouldn't have missed anything. Yeah, that's pretty much my thoughts on it, and I'm just gonna ultimately say that Mother is meh. It's not good, it's not bad, it's okay. It's not something I'm really ever going to watch again. I don't regret the experience of watching it, but it's whatever. It's not particularly anything that I cared for one way or another. It's an experience that I would say, have it once, and then just, you know, don't watch it again. All that being said, now I'm going to talk about some spoilers. What I expected was, you know, Aronofsky jerking himself off onto my face for 2 hours. What I got was Aronofsky jerking himself off onto the Bible for 2 hours. Guys, it's a metaphor for God and the creation of the earth through a really skewed Judeo-Christian lens. Jennifer Lawrence is Mother Earth, and Javier Bardem is God, and he loves her, but he loves people more, and he wants to be loved by the people, and he's letting them just fuck up the Earth, which is their house, and it's just... This movie doesn't leave you any room to interpret it any other way. There was a point about before the half-hour mark when Michelle Pfeiffer and Ed Harris first show up and they're fans of his and they want to, you know, be closer to him, I'm thinking, oh, it's a metaphor for the pitfalls of celebrity. They're being really intrusive and they're fucking shit up, but, like, they're doing it out of love for Javier Bardem. And then, you know, and then their sons show up and it becomes the most heavy-handed Cain and Abel metaphor you'll ever fucking see. And I mean, it was literally a moment of me being like, this isn't that heavy-handed. Oh, okay. And then from there, it just spirals the fuck out of control and it gets really absurd and really ridiculous and even more heavy-handed, especially when the fucking off-the-rails third act hits. Kristen Wiig's there for some fucking reason, I don't know. But it's just, you know, you get Jennifer Lawrence going through all the crazy shit that has happened to the Earth. Wars and riots and people eating babies and just a bunch of shit. It's really gets stupid, and then the ending is predictable, and like I said, if you pick up on the biblical metaphors, which it's kind of impossible not to, it just is really dumb, and you can read it from a mile away, and it's shoving the fucking Bible down your throat, and there's no room to interpret it as anything else, and it's really fucking awful because of that. That was the biggest letdown for this movie, is just how painfully obvious all of the symbolism was. They don't even try to hide it. They don't even try to give you any room to look at it a different way, and that's just super disappointing, especially in a film that could have been so much better had it been something that is able to be discussed. I've seen people saying that people are going to be talking about this for years. I'm like, I don't see how, because the meaning is right there, explicitly spelled out for you in the from the 30-minute mark onward. And it's just really ultimately disappointing, and I'm sad that it wasn't as good as it could have been. Like I said, not good, not bad, just kind of okay. I'd give it like a 6 out of 10 if I was doing ratings. It's good to be back, guys. I missed this. Got a couple more movies to catch up on from September. Don't worry, I'm going to fucking review It. I know y'all are requesting it. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching. We're at 1,100 subscribers because of you all, and I appreciate it so much. I appreciate you sticking with us through the hiatus that I took because of, you know, the sake of filming a movie. And click down there if you like us. You can like and comment and subscribe, and we'll have a lot more reviews coming up soon. Thanks, guys.